Hello everyone, this video is all about best ways for support agents to begin their day with Zoho Desk. How does every day begin for support agents? Well, it mostly begins with them responding to new tickets that came in overnight or early and customer responses for the previous day's tickets, reminders for previous week's and month's tickets, and working on pending tasks associated with these tickets. As a result, they're forced to hit the ground running. They hardly spend a moment analyzing their workload. They don't get to pace out their work through the day and feel bogged down by lunch. Planning your day helps you stay focused and do more in less time. Zoho Desk, in addition to being simple and easy to use, is built in such a way that agents can organize their work in the best possible manner, stay on track of their work, and focus on what's truly important. Now let's see how you, support agents, can begin your day with Zoho Desk to achieve maximum productivity. First thing to do once you log in is to check your scorecard. Agent scorecard is a dashboard that displays consolidated metrics on individual performance. It displays information about ticket statistics, response times, happiness ratings, and ticket volume. By default, the scorecard will display information for the last 7 days. You can customize it to view your performance over different time periods. Ticket statistics chart shows a channel-wise breakup of the total number of open, on-hold, and closed tickets you own. This will give you a sense of your workload for the day and help you pace out your day accordingly. The dashboard also displays KPIs like first response time, that is, the time taken for an agent to send out the first response to a ticket. And then we have average response time, which is the average time taken to respond to ticket replies. And then there is average resolution time, that is the average time taken to resolve a ticket. And then we have customer happiness ratings, which is a measure of how satisfied your customers are with your support experience. And finally, we have ticket volume in a graph format. This shows how many backlog tickets you own and how many tickets you've closed. Metrics in the scorecard get updated in real time, and agents get to know how better or worse they're performing when compared to the benchmark numbers and can focus on their areas of improvement. Zoho Desk takes the average of scores of all agents in a team to arrive at benchmark figures for each of these metrics. So now that you've gone over the scorecard, get a view of workload across departments. If you're associated with more than one department, this step will help you identify your tickets from the whole lot. To do that, go to Tickets module and choose All Departments. This view will display tickets from all departments in your help desk. Click the three dots you see here and select Filter and enter a criteria. I'm not going to choose departments because I want to see tickets from all the departments. Under Agent, I'm going to choose Yor Akbaria to see tickets from all departments that are assigned to him. You can also filter tickets by status, priority, and channel to get more details if needed. The last filter is due date. Now, I want to see only those tickets that are assigned to Yor across departments and which are due today and overdue already. So I'm going to select those two fields and filter my results. So there you go. You now have a list of tickets assigned to you and ones that need your immediate attention. Now that you know what your day is going to look like, it's time to organize your workload. Focus on tickets that are nearing their due time, followed by tickets from existing customers and other high priority tickets. Zoho Desk allows you to do this through work modes. There are four work modes, namely status, handshake, priority, and countdown mode. The status mode displays tickets by their status, like open, on hold, and closed. Handshake mode sorts tickets by customer type. It displays tickets from existing customers, potentials, and leads in separate columns. All you need to do is integrate your CRM with Zoho Desk and you'll be able to see relevant customer information here itself. Priority mode organizes tickets based on the criticality of the issue. Here you see high, medium, and low priority tickets displayed in separate columns. The last one is countdown mode, and it arranges tickets by due times like overdue, due in 1 hour, due in 6 hours or more. You can customize the work modes by adding or deleting filters. To do that, click on the three dots on the top right corner. It will display the filters associated with that particular work mode. If you want to delete a filter, click the delete option on the right side of it. Remember, you cannot delete the views that are set as default by your manager or anyone with administrative access. If you want to add or create a new column, you can do so by clicking here. Work modes are super smart. They don't require you to refresh the page to move tickets to their appropriate columns. To drill down further, pick out a ticket view of your choice. There are 13 views that come built-in with Zoho Desk. You can choose a ticket view either from the side panel or from here. Let's say you want to first focus on tickets that have violated service level agreements. Go to the ticket views option and choose SLA violated tickets. You'll notice that Zoho Desk displays tickets that fulfill the chosen criteria. So there you go. Now you have your tickets organized. You can also star your favorite views to access them easily. In addition to the default views, you can also create your own views. To do that, click the plus icon here. Enter a name for the view. I'll show you how to create a view for email tickets. Fill in the criteria. I'm entering channel is email. You can either keep the view private to you or make it visible to your entire team or a selected group of agents. Save and you're good to go. Now that you've organized and analyzed your workload, you will know if there are any ticket duplicates that have to be removed or if there are tickets that need transfer of ownership. I'll give you an example. In B2C organizations, it's very common to come across consumers who expect lightning-fast responses and tend to contact your team repeatedly via same or different channel until they get an answer. This situation results in your system receiving multiple tickets from same customer about the same issue. As you see here, this customer, Ashlyn, has written to ZPhone support twice about charging issues she's facing with her device. In such cases, you can simply merge those tickets and answer them all together instead of having to type out the same response individually to every ticket. To do that, select the tickets you'd like to merge. Choose the merge option. Review the fields that will appear in the merged ticket and merge. This way, you make sure you don't invest time in repetitive and redundant work and also resolve tickets faster and make your customers happy. You may also come across situations where your customers reply to their previous ticket thread with new requests. In those cases, you can split that particular message and create a new ticket. Sometimes, you may even have to transfer ownership of such new tickets to another department or team within your organization. For example, this customer, who first contacted you for issues with her Z-Pad, has replied to the same thread with a new request about her Z-Watch. In this case, splitting the ticket wouldn't suffice. You will have to share the ticket with Z-Watch department and also let your customer know that you're doing so. First, I'm going to split this conversation. Go back to tickets view and find the new ticket. Share the ticket with Z-Watch department. Reply to the ticket, CCing ZWatch support, and let everyone know that you're sharing it with another department. Now, let's switch over to ZWatch department to see if we have received this ticket. There it is. You can find the ticket shared by other departments in Shared Open Tickets view. Now that it's shared with ZWatch, they can take it from there and you can also keep track of progress of the ticket. That brings us to the end of this video. And I hope you found it useful. Do try out these capabilities and let us know about your experience in the comments below. If you have any other questions, feel free to tweet or write an email to our support team. Thanks for watching this video and stay tuned for more such content.